Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, in Jesus' name, I am so thankful, Father, that through your Son's blood, we can come boldly through the throne of grace and obtain mercy and grace to help in the time of need. Father, I thank you that you will help me bring this message forth, Father God, the way you want it. Because, Father God, as Pastor was saying this morning, Father, in your word says the Holy Ghost is our helper. And so I ask you, Father God, that to teach through me, Father God, whatever you want me to say, and help me to leave off what you don't want, Father. And I appreciate that. And give your children illuminated hearts, minds, to take in, Father God, what the Spirit is saying tonight. And I thank you in Jesus' name, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, I just have 1:20. Okay. Before returning to Africa, missionary Jack Evans will be discussing his personal faith struggle in suffering at a potluck supper. Just a little humor there. And I was going to name this, Speak Life and You'll Have Life in Your Life. Now, that ain't really too bad. It does make sense, but I figured it'd be too much for her to write on the CD and just go smack this down. Okay. Okay. Proverbs 18:21. I know y'all know this, okay. Proverbs 18:21. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit. Okay. Now, Genesis 1:1-3 says, In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters, the face of the waters. Then God said, Let there be light. And there was light. Now, I want you to notice, the Spirit of God was hovering over the water. The water was there. The darkness was there. The Spirit of God was there. But nothing happened. Until words were spoken. God's words were his creative power. And he has not changed because he changes not. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Words are energy. And energy affects matter. The energy of your microwave vibrates the water molecules, like you have to put a cup of water in there. It vibrates the water molecules and heats the water. The energy of electricity flows to your washing machine and powers the motor that spins the tub and cleans your clothes. So we can rightfully say that energy affects matter. Your words are energy, and they affect the matter in your life. I'm trying to get at this, how powerful the words in your mouth are. Things are responding to your words every day. So speak good things to all that surround your life. Now, Pastor said this, I probably haven't had revelation on it, but he said this. When you do that, good things will be drawn to you. You know, I haven't had revelations on that, but speak good things to everything. You know, like I got a good car, I got a good wife, I got a good house, I got a good job, I have a good dog, I have a good neighbor, because you can even have a neighbor total. Speak good things around there, you know. I did that for a while, and then you know how you schluff off, okay. I'm sorry, it was just me that schluffs, I'm sorry. Okay. Remember that life and death are in the power of your tongue. Jesus said in Luke 17:6, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it will obey you. Things obey words. It is written, speak to the mulberry tree and it will obey you. It's written in the word. Okay, I have a testimony to prove this. Anyways, Okay, I had a little white knob inside my nose, y'all, for months and months and months, and it bothered me, but my brain did not think, why don't you just take authority over it, you know? Maybe not. I won't look that way, but maybe not. Okay. She's over there. No. Just kidding, honey. So it's really like not, and so finally one day I thought, I'm just going to take authority over that thing. So I first thing I did was I said, it is written. Speak to the mulberry tree and it shall obey you. Okay. Okay. And then I said this, it is written. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law, having become a curse for me. And I quoted that I have been redeemed from the curse of the law. Okay. Pointed to my nose and said that. Now listen, I said it and said it and said it and said it day after day after day after day after day after day. I think, y'all, for about 2 weeks, okay? About 2 weeks, I'm not sure. It could have been 3 weeks, okay. Okay, and then the last week, it got real sore. And Satan was trying to put fear on me, like, well, you did it now. That was cancer, and look what you've done. Remember, whatever, you know how he does try to put fear. But I just kept saying, thank you, Lord, that you said we command things to leave our body, and we have been redeemed from the curse of the law. And I told her to dry up and leave my nose while it's gone.
Yes.
I didn't do that, honey. It's gone. Praise God forever. It's that the power of your tongue,
yes,
according to the word of God.
Yes.
Always according to the word of God. Okay. Okay. Speak to the mulberry tree and it shall obey you. Jesus was showing us a spiritual principle. We have dominion through the blood, even though in the Gospels he hadn't died yet, you know, but he was showing us a principle of you can have the same power I got, you know, and which we got now. Mm-hmm. Now, Kenneth Copeland says this, when you first see something on your body or feel something on your body, when you first see it, like I did last night, another testimony, I guess, he says, immediately take authority over it. Immediately take authority over it. Don't stand and think, gee, what is this? What is that? How did that get there? Don't do that. And don't describe it to somebody else, which we all do, which I'm doing, okay? So take authority over it. Command it to leave immediately. Okay. Well, my knee was stolen up. It just was stolen. I'm not that old. But it was stolen up, and I'm just thinking, you know. And I took authority over it, just because I knew I was teaching this, I took authority over it, you know. This morning it was a little bit sick, it's gone.
Right.
It was that, when you get inflammation, it was bad. Okay. We have authority. We have been redeemed from the curse. And of all sickness, all diseases, all lumps, itch, shingles, you know what I mean? Itch, I mean, it's in the Bible. Itch, pain, grief. Uh-huh. We have been redeemed from the curse of the law. I mean, I quote that, you know. We have been redeemed from the curse of the law, and all sickness and all disease is under the curse, but I ain't under the curse because Jesus became cursed for me. Amen. I mean, you know, like Pastor always says his things real fast. You just get to use it, say it real fast, okay? But I'm not under the curse, so leave my body, okay? Now listen to this. If you are in fear at all, go to the doctor. You know, I mean, you know, just go to the doctor. I like doctor. I go to the doctor, you know. In fact, if I would have caught this when I should have, y'all, maybe it wouldn't have happened, you know what I mean? I'm not positive, you know, but, okay. Any fear at all, go to the doctor, okay. The Word of God, conceived in the human spirit, then formed with the tongue, and spoken out of your mouth, releases the ability of God. You get the Word in your heart. You've got to put it in your heart by listening, meditating, and speaking God's word out loud. Try to get you to do that. This is it. Am I? I'm sorry. He's so good at being like, okay. Okay, now it's going into your heart. Faith comes, and faith comes by hearing.
Yes.
Okay, hearing yourself say it. Okay. Now, listen. Don't quote the devil's words.
That's right.
That's his negatives, okay? And one of them is, I'm zeroing in on, don't say ever, I'm depressed. Do not say the word suicide. I heard it from a great preacher who says, treat those words like profanity and vulgarity. Don't ever let them into your mouth, okay? Now listen, God knows you, he loves you, he knows when you're down, he knows it. You could, Hannah in the Bible poured out her heart to God.
Yes,
even though, you know, and just her lips were moving. You can do that, you know.
Yes.
But don't utter those words out of your mouth. It may open the door to the devil. Okay? Just don't do it. Okay. Okay. So let me tell you what to do instead. God says in Isaiah 61:3, put on the garment of praise for that spirit of heaviness, and that's just what it is, a spirit of heaviness, oppression, depression, suppression. Okay, now listen. When you're feeling down, put on a garment of praise. When you're down, you don't feel like praising. I'm just being, I've been there. You don't feel like praying. That's when it becomes a sacrifice of praise.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, God honors sacrifices. I mean, he really honors. You honor me, I will honor you. He says so. Okay. Okay. Now, getting back to your tongue, not mine. Your tongue. Okay. Your tongue is the mixer. You mix faith with the word of God by saying what God said. Okay. You are the mixer. Okay. 55:11 Isaiah. 55:11 Isaiah. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth, it shall not return to me void. I know you all know that, okay? Shall not. If God said it shall not return to me void. And this man, I got this from it. Paraphrase, listen to this. Paraphrase, for instance, God saying this, return my word to me and I'll perform it. Just return it to me. Just return it to me. I've been redeemed from the curse of the law. Just, you know what I mean? Return it to him. Now, 2 Corinthians 4:13. Since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believed and therefore I spoke. We also believe and therefore speak. It's a biblical principle. It's in the Bible. Whatever you believe, you will speak. Now, I speak over my eye all the time. I just speak over my eye all the time. I say, now, God gave me three words the day after I got some real bad news about my eye. Y'all don't know about it, but I ain't going to go into it. He gave me three words, recovery of sight. That's it. But I'm just the type of person, I run to the Bible and see if I can see those exact words somewhere. Well, they're in the Bible. The three exact words, recovery of sight. And so I say, I have recovery of sight in my right eye. And I say it, and a bunch of other scriptures I say, too. Just and I'll say, you know what? Father, I know Bartimaeus is in heaven, and he ain't blind, and I ain't blind. You know, and I just keep going with all them scriptures. You guys know how to stand.
Yes.
Praise you, Jesus.
Say, Jim.
Yes.
Hi, Jim. Okay, now that I made her feel that, okay. Listen, when you are standing in faith for something, always speak a scripture in line with it. And then just recently, I think just a couple days ago, God gave me one more. And I'm be honest with you, I don't just hear a voice very seldom, because maybe I don't want to even say I'm dull, but I mean, I just don't hear it that often. I hear songs, y'all. But I heard a complete another scripture. He says, it shall be even as it was told you. And that exact one is in the Bible. And so I've been saying, them two together. God is an encourager.
Yes,
if you're standing for something, boy, he just comes along and just does that.
Yes.
Good God.
Yes.
Good God.
Amen.
Always speak a scripture in line with what you're standing for. Okay. The more you speak it, the more you will believe it. And the more you believe it, will come to pass, the more it will be there. You think I got that a little wrong. You get it? Okay. Hebrews. 10:23. Don't tell Pastor, okay? Hold fast the confession of your hope, for he who promised is faithful. Oh, that's a powerful one. And that is a powerful, powerful scripture. 10:23, Hebrews. Hold fast. Okay. Psalms. Okay, now we're going to go into a little shift here. Psalms 103:20. New King James Version. Bless the Lord, you his angels, who excel in strength, who do his word, heeding the voice of his word.
Amen.
Voice translation. You heavenly messengers, you powerful creatures who listen and act on his word. Oh, look at that. Yeah, praise God forever. Concerning activities on earth, angels heed the voice of God's word as it is spoken through the saints on earth. The angels are listening to your words so they can perform them. That's why we can't go into the negative area. Stay in the positive area. Stay with God. Stay in agreement with God. Seriously. So, your words need to line up with God's words. God told Annette Katz this. He designed them as ministering spirits. They stand beside you daily, listening to the words that come out of your mouth. If your words line up with my words, God is speaking this. If your words line up with my words, then the angels have an assignment, and they go to work on your behalf. That's good. That's good. Praise God. I'm very happy over that. And you won't believe it. I was doing this on Saturday. I was very careful what come out of my mouth, y'all, because I knew they were listening. You know, it says, I knew they were listening, okay? Don't want to get paranoid about it, but, you know. Let's see. And then God went on to say to Annette Capps, my word is my will for man. Man was designed to speak truth, and my word is truth. Okay, and then that's all that he spoke. Okay, now, angels want very much to get involved in your personal affairs, in your home, in your business, in all aspects of your life. Hallelujah. For instance, you're short on your mortgage payment, maybe about $100 you're short, and you pray, and then you say, thank you, God, that you supply all my needs according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus, and you don't let off that. See, the angels are listening, and you don't say nothing else. This ain't going to work or something like that. Just stay with the scripture. The angels want to help you. They want to help you. I didn't even know this, and I was saying, in other words, I was short on my mortgage payment. I think it was, I don't know, it was $22 short, okay? And that day in the mail, God did say to me, this was a long, long time ago, he says, very, very quietly, the Holy Spirit said, why wouldn't he? And I thought, yeah! You know, you don't believe it, but I mean, the only thing I could do, nobody had come to my house, I ran out to my mail, there was a check for $35.
Yes.
Over and above 22.
Amen.
That's yes. Our God. Yes. I'm telling you, that is our God. That is our God.
Praise
God.
Right.
And on Philippians 4:19, you know that's that scripture to that. Okay. To supply all my needs. 4:19, Philippians. You say it every day, but just for instance, maybe five times a day, the angels are listening. If God says the angels listen and act on the word, you better believe if he said it, then they're working.
Yes.
Okay. They are going to work on your behalf. Just keep speaking the scripture because of our faithful God. Okay. They are ministering spirits of God here on earth to minister for you and assist you in your life. The power of life and death are in your tongue. So use your tongue for life. Don't say, I just can't remember. Madeline, I know we're all guilty of this. I'm sorry to say. Okay. Don't say you can't remember things. Don't say my kids are driving me crazy. Say instead something real simple. I have the mind of Christ. Just come up to me, Patty. I don't care what you say, buddy. I got the mind of Christ. You know, I don't know what she's going through. And that is 1 Corinthians 2:16. I have the mind of Christ. 1 Corinthians 2:16. Angels listen to see if your words agree with God's words. God has made these angels available to minister to you who are heirs of salvation. Hebrews 1:14. Hebrews 1:14. Okay. All I'm going to say is watch what you say out of your mouth. Listen, Joyce Meyer said this a while back too, listen to what just come out of your mouth. You can repent. God honors repentance. Thank God for repentance. Mm-hmm. You know, but try to listen to what is coming out of your mouth. God is a positive God. That's his perspective, is positive. Okay, good, success, and all that good stuff. You know, overcomer, conqueror, victorious in Jesus Christ. That's God. Make your words to be in agreement with God. Not negative words, that's the devil's words. And remember, the angels are listening to your words, and they are here to help you. Praise God forever.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. By the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony.